Welcome again. This is Dr. V. H. Atpalliwar. Taking nerve cell as an important thread in medicinal chemistry, we will have a brief on nerve cell. Now, this is indeed a diagrammatic representation of a nerve cell. Nerve cell is also called as neuron. A neuron is nucleated. It contains dendrites, these parts. It is myelinated, and this terminating part is called as axon. These axon forms junctions that are connections with another neuron. It connects with dendrites, or it also forms connections with muscle cell. Those muscle cells are called as effector organs. The point of junction is termed as synapse. This diagrammatic representation depicts a particular synapse. A synapse essentially contains a presynaptic nerve ending, which is a part of one neuron, and postsynaptic nerve ending, which is essentially a part of another neuron. It can also form, as said earlier, a synapse between a presynaptic nerve ending and a postsynaptic organ, that is effector organ, a muscle cell. The space in between the junction is called as synaptic cleft. It may also be called as extra neuronal compartment. It is filled with a fluid which is called as synaptic fluid. Now, the membrane of nerve cells or muscle cells are densely populated with proteinous structures called receptors. These receptors are located both presynaptically as well as postsynaptically. These receptors are of different types. The neurotransmitters are released into the synaptic cleft as a response of arrival of a signal. Corresponding signal triggers the release of the neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft, and the synaptic cleft, they have to travel and interact with these receptors. Now, you may take a pause, think it over of whatever we have seen about a synapse, write it in your journal. Welcome back. You may have indeed written something about a synapse and the neurotransmitters. Now, the neurotransmitters which travel this synaptic cleft and reach the receptors to interact with. The neurotransmitters may interact with the receptors located presynaptically or postsynaptically. The receptor which is located presynaptically and which allows the neurotransmitter to interact with it, they are called as autoreceptors. The receptors which are available postsynaptically have different mechanism of action. They are available in the membrane, they transverse the membrane, hence they are called transmembrane receptors. They are proteinous in nature. Interaction between the neurotransmitter and the receptor are called as ligand receptor binding interactions. These binding interactions are reversible. These reversible interactions bring about some conformational changes in the protein structure. These conformational changes then bring about some changes intracellularly, which leads to the pharmacological effect. enzymes which patrol this synaptic cleft, which are distributed into the synaptic fluid, they metabolize the neurotransmitters. That is, they change their structure. Change in the structure culminates the interaction between the ligand, that is the neurotransmitter, and the receptor, which reverts back the receptor to its original conformation, thereby culminating the pharmacological actions. Thank you.